focus on your projector and adjust the volume control during the count which follows. Testing, 1, 2, 3, 4. What is that to me? What is that to me? The world is full of sadness. What is that to me? Children without a daddy, that is it can be. But a wife without a husband, today's world, to shut out of our minds those unpleasant things that happen around us. That is, of course, until they happen to us or one of our close working associates. Then it means a lot to us. So today we'd like to take the advice of an old prophet who said, let us sit and reason together and see if we can eliminate as many probabilities as possible of something happening to you or one of your close working associates. Just for the record, right on American Airlines ramp, people have been killed, crippled for life, lost their jobs, and even fined by the FAA upwards of $1,000 for negligence in the operation of aircraft on the ground involving bodily injury to a fellow employee. Serious? Yes, very serious. Last year, it cost fellow AA employees, such as yourself, 23,000 man days of lost employment. Think of that a minute. $800,000 down the drain in lost income due to injury on the job. That's almost $1 million, and the loss of it touched many lives. It cost $91,000 last year to repair ground equipment, not to mention the many hours lost resolving the responsibility of the accident. Aircraft damage amounted to $3 million in repairs, plus putting the various aircraft out of service for 4,000 hours. An untold loss of revenue, which is the wherewith that makes our paychecks good at the supermarket. We've come a long way since the days of the Ford Trimotor, when a ground man handled baggage, gas, and oil, the aircraft, and even helped take tickets. This jack-of-all-trades individual filled a vital role in our growth and development that has led us to the threshold of one of the most complex operations of modern man. An operation that requires from each of us the professional skill and attitude necessary to meet the ever-increasing demands of the public. Safe, on-schedule transportation at a tremendously accelerated pace. With the advent of the Superjet, the Boeing 747, the McDonnell Douglas DC-10, and the new increased route structure, we are embarking on transportation endeavors that stagger the imagination of many people, even today. With this increased activity comes increased responsibility in the safety area. You are all professionals in your own area, many of you drawing larger paychecks than some college professors. We feel that an informed professional can evaluate and can conduct himself accordingly. What do you consider to be the biggest single contributing factor to accident involvement? One of the first things that comes to our mind is speeding, always in a hurry. Well, this certainly does contribute. Our very business is one of expediting people. Speeding is a product of the time. We all race on our way to work on the freeway. Freeways have their share of wipeouts. Freeway clearance is not enough when people in unprotected vehicles and $5 million aircraft are involved. Yes, speeding does take its toll, but speeding is not the number one offender. Carelessness, yes. Carelessness can be very costly, especially when the odds stack up against us. We've all gotten away with careless acts from time to time, but one careless moment at the wrong time can cost us our life. Yes, carelessness is bad, but still not the chief offender. An independent, unforgiving attitude can be disastrous. I'm in the right, and I'll run over him to prove it. It doesn't buy much peace of mind when someone gets hurt. We've covered the common reasons we usually attribute to accident involvement, but we still haven't hit on the main offender. We've researched the subject at stations having heavy accident losses, and at stations with practically no accident involvement. Our findings have uncovered the biggest single factor of accident involvement, and that is the maybe situation. Maybe I can clear this wingtip without a guide man. Maybe I can get away with speeding on the ramp. No one's watching. Maybe it's okay to park too close just this one time, just as long as he doesn't move first. Maybe I can get by with careless chocking on this aircraft. Maybe I can save time ducking under the tail. Wow, if that door had dropped a few seconds later, it would have wiped me out and the door. Yes, many times you luck out, but when you don't, well, that's what the 23,000 lost working days is all about. And that's $3 million worth of aircraft damage. Or worst of all, loss of yourself or your buddy. No, we can't eliminate all of the accidents, but many can be prevented if we adopt the attitude of eliminating the maybe situation. Regardless of what your job is, the prime prerequisite is to perform it safely. Stop the action if in doubt and eliminate the maybe. To help us achieve a better safety record, local management has been alerted to provide you with full support. But the big job, my friends, is up to you. Let's take a look at some of the accidents that have happened repeatedly at American Airlines stations throughout the system this year and see what's causing the accident rate to rise. Hurry and carelessness together can create a maybe situation, such as this mechanic who didn't have time to check the hose stowage before the truck was removed, but he had plenty of time after the flight was delayed for manifold repairs. Let's watch this gentleman a few moments. In a hurry to remove a liquor case, a quick stop, and a big maybe that the brakes are set. Maybe leaving the engine running is harmless. Or is it? An unmanned truck coasting into the side or wing of an airplane can cause plenty of damage. Yes, this really happened. Let's watch a recap of an accident that seriously injured a mechanic this year. Thank you. synonym, the unpleasant but inevitable meeting that always follows an accident, using fictitious people to illustrate our point.
Mr. Naylor, my phone is good.
Yes, Fred. As you're aware, you were involved in an accident causing serious injury to a fellow employee. Immediately after this accident, an investigation was held, which you participated in. Later, a complete hearing was held where all available facts were brought out and testimony was heard from available witnesses. After reviewing these facts, I find, Fred, that you violated several company regulations and existing policies. One, backing a vehicle on the route without a guide in a congested area. And Fred, that's quite some distance, as you remember. Two, failure to check an area to keep it clear before moving a vehicle. Also, Fred, as you remember, several witnesses testified that the vehicle was moving at a high rate of speed in reverse. Of course, as you know, after considering these facts, and not failing to recognize the seriousness of this injury and of the accident, it's my responsibility, Fred, to spell out the action to be taken. This I have done. I'm giving you 7 days off without pay as disciplinary action. I said I hope that this leaves such an impression on you that you will think back and you will think possibly preventing any reoccurrence of this type of action. Fred, that's about all I have. However, at this time, before you leave, I'd like to give you the opportunity to comment on the investigation, the hearing, the accident itself, or the disciplinary action. If you have any comments, please feel free to give them.
I would like to say I'm very sorry, and I would like to also ask how Dale is doing.
Fred, Dale's in serious condition. He'll be in the hospital quite some time. In fact, Fred, there's some doubt as to a complete recovery.
I find that this experience is very bad, and I would like to prevent it from happening anything on this nature in the future.
Thank you, Fred.
This practice can be fatal. It's like playing Russian roulette with a two-ton truck. Extra caution must be used at night or in bad weather, or when construction equipment is located on the ramp. Or we can wipe out a wing tip, like this 727 that got caught in one of those maybe situations. And there is one distraction that's difficult to overcome, but very, very costly if we don't. Situation is an accident waiting to happen. Let's be sure we know what we're doing and eliminate the maybe on the ramp. As we mentioned, management has been alerted to give you full support in an all-out effort to reduce accidents. Now, this support includes careful screening of new hires to maintain our professional standards that are tops in the industry. Both initial and recurrent training to keep you up to date on operational procedures and equipment changes and safety regulations. Individual instruction on all equipment you'll be expected to use. Thorough enough to satisfy the instructor that you can instantly put your hand on the emergency brake and other controls, even blindfolded. Improperly operated heavy equipment is a potential danger to our working associates. Records will be kept and posted showing what equipment you're qualified to use, so you or any of your supervision can readily confirm your driver authorization, again, eliminating the maybe situation. Someone will be assigned to safety check each piece of equipment to be used with a station each day, with a signed card stating okay or discrepancy. Repairs of a safety nature will be accomplished immediately. Proper parking space will be designated by yellow lines for parking of all equipment. Of course, designated areas are a lot like stop signs. They're only effective if they're used. Quite a bit has been said in times past about how much longer it takes to do something right than to do it wrong. Well, for the most part, it really doesn't take any longer. It's like playing ball. A pitcher can pitch just as easily right as wrong, if he practices pitching the right way all the time. Pilot instructors have been advocating for years not to make any mistakes in the air because the airplane is terribly unforgiving. We've come to realize in the last few years that automobiles on the freeways are terribly unforgiving in the space. The schedule demands of today's operation result in a lot of congestion around the aircraft, and this, too, is becoming very unforgiving of mistakes. So make eliminating maybe situations one of the tools of your trade. Use it for the preservation of life, limb, and your job.